Petersburg, Florida, weighing 237 pounds. To my left, Barry Horowitz.
Barry Horowitz will challenge Flying Brian here on World Championship Wrestling. What a great program it's going to be. The Road Warriors to meet two of the four horsemen in this program. Two great hours for you, Jim Ross and Jim Cornette. And we've been joined, ladies and gentlemen, here at our vantage point by Mr. Wrestling 2, who will be in the Omni on Father's Day night, that's June 17th, as a special referee when Lex Luger and the Junkyard Dog take on Barry Windham and Ric Flair. Wrestling 2, welcome to WCW.
Well, thank you very much. It's going to be a real pleasure to be at the Omni. And I guarantee you one thing, it's going to be a lot of excitement. JYD is a very powerful individual. As I said before, he can handle any situation at any given time. And, you know, it gave me such great pleasure to see Ole Anderson, Ric Flair, get a little bit of their own medicine.
I want to know something, Wrestling 2. Like I said last week on the program, you've won more wrestling matches in the Omni than most wrestlers have won wrestling matches, period. I want to know, you're a hothead. Are you going to be able to stay strictly a referee? Are you going to be able to keep out of the action? Are you going to be able to hold yourself back from letting that knee lift loose and knocking somebody silly? Or are you going to be partial toward Junkyard Dog?
Well, let's just say that that's for me to know and for you to find out. The horseman has, the four horsemen has a big surprise coming towards them again. And let them just stand back and see what it's going to be all about. I can guarantee you one thing, the Junkyard Dog is a man of his word, and he said that he's going to take care of this business of these guys going out and hurting people every time they turn around is going to come to an end.
Well, Junkyard Dog and Lex Luger is going to be an odd combination. I don't know whether you know Luger or not, but together, they're going to be one heck of an interesting tag team.
Flying Brian, great movement here against Barry Horowitz. And there's a dropkick. Flying Brian, an outstanding young competitor. And he's following the footsteps of a man much like Mr. Wrestling 2. Flying Brian believes in fair play and good sportsmanship, and may the best man win. That's the way I think Wrestling 2 will referee in the Omni on Father's Day. May the best team win.
That's exactly right. There won't be no interference from outside, because I'll see to that, and I'll guarantee you that it will be the best man win.
You think Flying Brian believes that the best man will win? Well, the best man won at Capital Combat when the Midnight Express beat him and Z-Man, so I guess that means that Flying Brian believes he ain't the best man.
Well, this is a great young athlete, I'll tell you that, and whether it's in singles or tag team competition with his great partner, the Z-Man, this is an outstanding young competitor. Collar and elbow tie up, and Barry Horowitz back into the corner. A very underrated athlete, and a straight right hand took advantage of the officiating position there, inverted atomic drop.
Barry Horowitz is taking it to Flying Brian, and while we've got Mr. Wrestling number two here, your opinion on the big main event match today. What about it? It's going to be none other than the Road Warriors, the Legion of Doom, taking on two of the four horsemen.
I think the two of the four horsemen are going to have another uprun surprise, because as you well know, that they are the... Those two men are very well built, very powerful, and they know what wrestling is all about, and I think they can hold their own against anybody.
We'll find out a little bit later in this two-hour broadcast. The Legion of Doom will take on the Horsemen. And there's a big chop by Flying Brian. Fans, if you missed our dynamic broadcast last week, when the Junkyard Dog took on Ole Anderson and Ric Flair, we'll show you what happened a little bit later in our broadcast, and we'll hear some comments from the Dog as Barry Horowitz now tries to open up the offense.
Boy, I tell you right now, Flying Brian's breath is smelling like Kiwi boot polish, because that Barry Horowitz has been staying on him. He has given Pillman a lot more trouble than some would have given him credit for being able to do. But look at Pillman.
Pillman up for the top rope with a double axe and a blow on Barry Horowitz. This is action much like the fans in Baltimore will see tonight at 8 o'clock. And tomorrow afternoon, the NWA. Tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock. 3 in the afternoon in Asheville, North Carolina. Two phenomenal cards.
Well, as you can all see right there, Flying Brian has had enough, and he's retaliating and giving a little bit of the guy's medicine right back.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's got a hot temper just like I know that you do, but you see what Barry Horowitz did? He capitalized on a mistake, and Pillman over the top rope, but he held on.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
And the
beautiful
cat right
move.
There. Horowitz is, he's talking to the referee. Here may be his wake-up call. Flying Brian poised on the top. And crossbody. What a move. And Flying Brian has won it.
I'm just going to tell you, sometimes you've got to pay attention to what you're doing.
To Mr. Wrestling 2. We'll see him in the Omni on Father's Day night.
Well, here you see the instant replay. Horowitz violated the cardinal rule of baseball. Never take your eye off the ball, or in this case, the Brian, a victory.